السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1866 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the first of Jumad al-Ukhra. It was on the first of Jumad al-Ukhra 1375, the 2nd of January 1958, the director of secondary education in Tunis, a French national known as Jean Tobias, prepared a 60-page document called the Education Reform Project, calling for the cancellation of religious subjects and sciences from the syllabus, justifying his stance by stating that it is too costly. Let us just turn this the other way around. Imagine that they have certain syllabi in France, and an Arab country goes there and tells them that you have to remove this A, B, C, X, Y, Z. What will they tell the Arabs or the Muslims? That you are thugs, you are a terrorist, you are fundamentalist, and so forth. This is the problem with the white right and the white hegemony. I don't say all, but we'll say majority or many of them. They want to maintain that superiority of the white person, the white man. As we know, yeah, in apartheid South Africa, till today you will see it in America and many parts of Europe. Now, if you go to North Africa, Tunisia, Tunis, this is the plight of the Muslim Ummah and the Arabs especially, that they have been indoctrinated and brainwashed, remember this, and so much so, majority of the youth and the people think the West is the best and that white is right. They look down upon Islam, they look down upon the Muslim beard, the Muslim attire, the hijab, the niqab, and it was banned also for certain times. And remember, I've been to Tunisia and Tunis. It's a beautiful, wonderful country. The people are good. It's the governments and the politicians, majority of them, that are corrupt. And because of the French holding them to ransom, so with financial aid, military aid, and others and so forth. So therefore, instead of speaking of independence, independence is just a game they play. Their minds are not independent from the yoke of the French and the European and the Western culture and American culture. So that is what the problem is. Today the Muslim will read, Ihdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. O Almighty Allah, you guide us and show us the right path. Sirat al-Ladina namta alayhim, the path of those upon whom you conferred your bounties and favors, referring to minan nabiyyin wa siddiqeen wa shuhada wa salihin, the messengers, the prophets, peace be upon them, the Siddiqeen, those who are very, very truthful, the martyrs and the pious, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَدَّالِينَ, not those upon whom your wrath and anger has descended, the Jews, nor those who are astray and the Christians, as the tafsir commentary was made by Habibuna Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. But today this Ummah, Arab, non-Arab, 90%, 95% of the Muslim Arab countries love the West, love the Jews, love the Christians, say white is right, consider Muslims to be second class, third class citizens. So ghar ko aag lag gayi ghar ke chirag se, we have a problem within our own houses that we look down upon Islam, whereas Islam, as Sayyidina Umar said, nahnu qawmun a'azzana Allah bil Islam, only Islam will give us honor and dignity as a nation, as a people. وَمَهْمَا نَتْلُبُ غَيْرَهُ لَأَذَلَّنَ اللَّهُ, and seek any other ism, it's a recipe and a disaster for humiliation and disgrace. May Almighty Allah guide our Arab brothers, Muslim brothers, sisters, and the entire Ummah to the right path. May Almighty Allah protect us from the evil. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.